I would like to invite Mr. Hitesh Asrani, Executive Director and Chief Financial Officer of CRP. Mr. Hitesh Asrani.
Good morning. If I have to speak, I have to ensure everybody is awake. So. But I would like to start with thanking all the people on the dais, Neeraj ji, Ajay ji, Arvind ji, and of course, Raza and Nisha, and all the people who have taken the time, effort, and woken up early to join us for this very memorable moment in our journey. So thank you so much, you know. So there was something that I had heard very early in my life. This is a part of something called the Ganesh Stotra, and it goes this way. It says, Vidyarthi labhate vidya, dhanarthi labhate dhana, putranthi labhate putram, mokshanthi labhate gatir. And what it basically means is that whatever we are seeking with a focused mind and with a single-mindedness is what we achieve in our life. What it means is that we are creating our own destiny and we are creating our own world that is surrounding us. And all it takes is that one single-mindedness to create that. So when I heard this, and I was a very young guy at that point in time, the first thought that came to my mind was that, okay, if that's what it takes, then why should I limit my ambition to something as limited as myself? Or as limited as my own, you know, limited family. If this be true, and I know that it is, that we are creating our own world, then why not create a larger family? A family that is going to encompass not only me, not only my family, but the well-being of all the people that are coming into this world. My team, our vendors, our financiers, our partners, our bankers, our consultants, anybody who touches us in our life, if we truly believe is our family, then suddenly we are actually creating a good world for our family. It's just that we are changing the definition. And it is with this thought that the seeds of CRP were sown. It is from this thought that CRP is sprouted, that let's create a bigger family. And that's how we had started off at that point in time. Now, from a time when we started in an office space which was 50 square feet, where one person had to go out for the third person to come in, when we started our journey, to today, where we are creating employment, either directly or indirectly, for more than 3,000 people, which for us translates into 15,000 people, including their families, whom we are impacting positively, I think CRP has come a very long way. Now the journey of a small plant vis-a-vis the journey of a, let's say, a mango tree is a very different journey. A small plant, very quickly you will see a flower coming in and you might say, oh, this is success. But then if you want to create something which is going to give shade and which is going to give fruits for a long, long time, then there are a few tenets that are very important. And these tenets are the fact that you need to trust your own vision. You need to know what you're going behind. What has to happen in this journey is the fact that you need to be focusing on your fruits, on your roots. Because it is our roots that are our fundamental nature. And the roots have to go deep if the plant and the tree has to, you know, become a large tree. And this is what we have done at CRP. Right through this journey, we have been focusing on our roots. We have been focusing on the fundamentals. And the fundamental things that we are focusing on include the fact that we have to create an organizational attitude of continuous introspection. We have to keep on introspecting on seeing how we can become better. Doesn't mean that we are not going to make mistakes. Yes, we might. But if our focus is completely on our own introspection, then the roots are becoming stronger. And on this journey, we have weathered a lot of storms that have come on our way. But then storms are not in our hand. It is our roots that are in our hand. and we are focusing completely on our role. And we are trying to become a better organization as we are going ahead from here. But at the same time, it doesn't mean that we are just going to be working seriously. Yes, we are working seriously, but we are celebrating every success as we are going ahead. No matter whether it's a small success or a big success. So between our introspective nature and our celebrating nature, we have been able to cover this journey from that small office to the current situation where we have reached. Now today, when I'm standing here, as far as that young company is concerned, you know, it seems as if the horizon that I could see when we started this company, we have already reached that horizon. And then when you reach here, you realize that every horizon is a myth. Because when I'm standing here, I'm seeing another horizon which is actually waiting for us. And it is larger, bigger, more encompassing. And it is in this new era that we have to continue with a lot of lessons that we have picked up from our formative years in which we have learned so many things. There's a lot we can carry into this era. To start with, we carry the support, grace and blessings of a lot of good people that have come into our world. God has been kind on us right through the journey. And I am carrying grace as a constant companion in my heart. So that is something that we need to carry from here onwards. The other thing that we are taking forward is the fact that all the people, and there have been so many people that have come into our lives, and invariably, the people that we are meeting are good people. They are genuinely good people. And it could be our partners, it could be our staff, it could be our friends, it could be our consultants, it could be our... We have encountered so many good people. And we are carrying the good wishes. And we are wearing their trust and faith in us as a badge of honor. Because on our balance sheet of life, it is these relationships that are very precious assets for us. It's not only what is coming on our financial balance sheet. We are carrying this faith with us into our life. At this point in time, there are large number of corporates, some of the largest in India, who are trusting our services. They are trusting our solution building capabilities. They are trusting the fact that we are able to implement large projects all across India. Now this trust is what we are carrying forward into the future. And it is not only the fact that we are having a large number of clients. Yes, that is a matter of pride. But what is a bigger matter of pride is the fact that most of these customers have been with us for over a decade. And the fact that somebody stays with you for such a long time, it means that it gives us a feeling that yes, we have been adding value. We have been adding value, and that is something that is really making us feel good. And we have to remember and carry the fact that this trust of our customers is something that is a very serious responsibility that we are carrying forward. And we will do everything that we can to ensure that we are delivering exceptional results to them from here onwards. A word for Raza. You have been with us from the very first day since we started the journey. And you have stood as a rock, you know, as far as in the journey that is concerned. And CRP would not have been the same without what we have done. Customers, you know, it could not have happened if you were not enjoying your work. And that is a facet that I cannot teach you. We can teach, we can do a lot of trainings on process, we can do a lot of trainings on how to, you know, become better in our delivery and everything. But I cannot train you to actually enjoy work. That is something that you have to bring to the table yourself. So a great round of applause for the young and dynamic team of CRP. You know, I am very blessed to have you all, you know, in the office. And if I may, I would like to take a pledge today as I stand here. But this is a pledge that I am not taking as Hitesh Asrani. I am taking this pledge on behalf of this entire team. So what I speak here now is something that I am speaking on your behalf. And this is something that we will be carrying into the future, you know, because you know that this is your commitment that I am making here, you know, on this public forum. To our customers, we will continue working with integrity. As long as our intentions are right, as long as we are not taking shortcuts, as long as we are keeping integrity as our benchmark, we will solve. If there are any delivery issues, we will solve. We will do everything that is possible to ensure that what they are doing. So this is a commitment that we have to make to our customers. They cannot think that we have not tried enough, and then they cannot think that we have not delivered the right results. That is a commitment that we are making to our customers. To our team, and I am making this commitment to our team, from our team, that we are going to support each other. We are going to support each other in trying to ensure that we all grow together. And then when I say we are going to grow together, I am not talking about the fact that we are only going to grow financially. Yes, we are going to grow financially together. But when we look back, we should know that we have grown together as better human beings. Because at the end of the day, we are spending 10 hours together. And in that 10 hours, it cannot just be a financial transaction or thought that will be happening. We have to ensure that we are becoming better human beings as we are going ahead. To our new family, as Ajayji and Neeraji said, more than 2,000 people have invested their hard-earned money and their faith into CRP, with the fact that they understand CRP stands for the right values. Now that, for us, this new family, for us, is a responsibility. We are committed to ensure that we are going to be giving them transparency and continuously demonstrating the fact that we are taking this responsibility very seriously as far as the investors are concerned. And finally, to the society. We have always looked at our P&L and we have gauged success, you know, year after year. Okay, how has this year been as compared to the last year? But we have always taken employment generation as one of the benchmarks to gauge our success. We will continue to keep focusing on directly or indirectly creating as much employment opportunities as possible. The more employment that we create, the more lives we will impact positively. So that is a commitment that we all have to together make to create as many employment opportunities as we can as we go along. And a few words of thanks to everybody. You know, this is a time I would like to thank my parents. Thank you so much. Really, you all have... Thank you for letting me fly. You know, really, you all have been the wind behind, you know, beneath my wings. So your blessings is something that has worked really for me. And my sisters, Didi, Deepa and their families. You all have been my lucky charm. So thank you so much. You know, the love that my sisters bring is something that... And my uncles, aunties and my family from the in-law side. Two joint families. I am so blessed. And it is the joint families and the love that has come to me, which has actually continued, not only laid the foundation of my own personal values, but has retained those values for me. So, thank you so much for being with me. And finally, our chairperson, Nisha, who also happens to be my wife, and my son, Devesh. Thank you. Because you all have stood with me across all seasons. And you all have stood with me with a smile on your face, no matter if it's a summer in our life or winter in our life, it doesn't matter. You all have stood with me and you all have had a smile on your face right through. So yes, I am very blessed. I am very blessed. And thank you so much. You all have played a bigger role in this than you all realize. So thank you so much for that. And while I cannot really name, you know, all the wonderful, glorious people who have impacted this journey so much, you know, it is, I would still like to name a few people, you know, whose contributions have and love has been really monumental in our journey. Mr. Ashish Parekh, who actually introduced me to credit controls. Ashish is not here today, but his name deserves a mention because I did not even know credit control existed. And he was the one who talked to me the first time about credit controls, and he was the one who actually planted this idea in my mind. Mr. Pankaj Vyas, Mr. Jitendra Sehi, who gave me a 3,000 square feet office when I was a young kid trying to be, when I could not even afford a 300 square feet office. Sir, your continuous generosity and kindness, really, you know, for standing with me even till date, you know, is unsurmountable. So thank you so much for all the support that you've given me. Mr. Sundar Krishnan, who is the CRO of Reliance Life, he's running a little late. But yes, he has really worked very hard and he's been with us for a very long time. So yes, that goes. Mr. Kamal Nidawat, who's here, thank you so much. I don't see you here, but God is kind, you know. Dinesh Bhai, for all the guidance and love and the loving things to, you know, train us in everything that we have been doing. Dinesh Bhai's contribution has been monumental. Sumit Chauhan, Harish Gangarmani, Thurat Sir, Rajesh Hangurde, Ritu Asadkar, Rahul Paisa, Surendra Hegde, Ashish Maheshwari, all people who at every opportune time have stood with us in such glorious ways, and they have really gone out of their way, out of the limits of what they were supposed to do, you know, in trying to support us. It is this love that has really taken us ahead. And I'm sure there are so many more. I'm so sorry if I have missed a few names, but just the number of people who have been with us are so many that, you know. So thank you so much, everybody who has been here. And then a special word of thanks to Ajay Thakurji. Sir, your drive, enthusiasm, passion, it is truly contagious. I'm telling you, you know. And what you have done is that you have given a young company like us a different worldview of looking at, you know, how we can actually mold our destiny from here onwards. So thank you so much. I owe a lot to your enthusiasm and to your drive. And finally, this quote that I had heard from Osho, and that is something that I have, that I relate to, you know, as more of a life mantra. And our life cannot be different in at our workplace and our house and our, you know, relationships and it's all the same. Actually, there are no boundaries. It's all the same. So this is something that has inspired me a lot, and it's a slightly long quote, so I have to read it. Start living moment to moment, totally and intensely, joyfully and playfully, and you will see that nothing goes out of control. Your intelligence will become sharper, that you become younger, that your love becomes deeper. And when you go out in the world, wherever you go, spread life, playfulness, joy as far as you can to every nook and corner of the earth. So with this thought, let's spread joy everywhere. Thank you so much for having joy. And yes, God is kind, of course.
Congratulations on this enriching journey and this achievement of being able to touch thousands of lives positively.